Good YouTube, it's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, now rumors and speculation are surfacing and running rampant after undefeated three-division world champion, whom at one point simultaneously held the World Boxing Association, better known as the WBA, sanctioned body belt, three all simultaneously at one time at 130, the super title, 135, 140, the regular title, that being superstar boxer Gervonta Tank Davis. 25 wins, no loss and no draws, 24 wins by way of knockout. He is 27 years of age, stands at 5'5" with a 67-inch arm reach. Well, with that said, ahead of a highly anticipated title showdown, two-time welterweight world champion superstar boxer Showtime Sean Porter, 31 wins, 3 losses, 2 draws, 17 wins by way of knockout. He is 34 years of age, stands at 5'7" with a 69-inch arm reach. They had a glorified sparring session. Now, Sean Porter, he's going into a mega title showdown with undefeated three-division world champion, former junior welterweight undisputed world champion, currently the WBO welterweight world champion, who is widely considered by many to be the number one best pound-for-pound fighter in the world, in Terrence Bud Crawford. With that said, Terrence Crawford, 37 wins, no losses, no draws, 28 wins by way of knockout, 34 years of age, 5'8" with a 74-inch arm reach. Now, Terrence Crawford, he has the ability to switch from orthodox to southpaw very fluently, okay? And so, Terrence Crawford's biggest wins and his most successful stance seems to come when he's in a southpaw stance. Now, we know Gervonta Tank Davis is a very, very explosive southpaw. He has a great left hand, okay? So with that said, it made sense for Sean Porter, in a sense, to spar Gervonta Tank Davis. But many people, they looked at the sparring session, they say, well, Gervonta Tank Davis is a 135-pound fighter, but his last fight was at junior welterweight at 140 when he took on Mexican undefeated rising star boxer Mario Barrios for his WBA regular title, okay, which he got a knockout victory over Mario Barrios. But that was at 140. So if the weight limit is at 140, Gervonta Tank Davis is known to blow up in weight in between fights. I'm sure the night of the fight, Gervonta Tank Davis was at least 150, okay? So with that said, now we know father, trainer, and manager Kenny Porter, he reveals that Gervonta Tank Davis was at least at 152, and Sean Porter was at 154, okay? So that means that they were only about 2 pounds off. Not to mention, Sean Porter is not the biggest welterweight in the world at 5'7" with a 69-inch arm reach. Tank Davis is 5'5" with a 67-inch arm reach, okay? So he's only about two inches taller than Gervonta Tank Davis, and he has maybe an arm reach advantage over Gervonta Tank Davis. And again, Gervonta Tank Davis is known to blow up in weight in between fights, okay? So Kenny Porter, he lets it be known that Gervonta Tank Davis, he was at least 150 to 152 pounds that night, okay, when they sparred. They only sparred once. So Gervonta Tank Davis, he did an interview in which he alluded to Sean Porter got wind and got the understanding that I'm an elite fighter. You know, like he sent Sean Porter a statement. But in reverse, he stated that Sean Porter is still a very good elite fighter as well. So it may have been nip and tuck, but you get the sense that Gervonta Tank Davis was alluding to he got the better of the two. And he stated, at least I know I could hold my own at welterweight, and so does Sean Porter. And Sean Porter knows that I'm an elite fighter. So it alludes to him getting the best of Sean Porter, okay? Now you have to look at it from this standpoint. Gervonta Tank Davis, he's going into a fight himself against Isaac Pitbull Cruz. This is scheduled to take place December 5th, Los Angeles, California, at the Staples Center. Isaac Pitbull Cruz, his style is somewhat of Sean Porter, okay? He's very aggressive, very pressure fighter. Sean Porter is a pressure fighter. He's going to press you every second of every minute of every round, okay? And so with that said, their styles, you know, Isaac Pitbull Cruz style and Sean Porter is somewhat comparable, okay? So you can understand the reason for them sparring one another. And according to Gervonta Tank Davis, Barry Hunter, his new trainer, reached out to Gervonta Tank Davis and asked him if he wanted to spar Sean Porter, and he obliged him. He said, why not? Okay. Now, I have to say this. You have to understand and believe that Sean Porter is working on a tactic, okay? He's working on things. He's preparing himself. Sean Porter is not going all out as if he's in a true boxing match, okay? Because I'm seeing people feeling like, you know, Gervonta Tank Davis can beat Sean Porter, knock out Sean Porter, and things of that nature. We had Gervonta Tank Davis being, you know, considered for opponent for former unified welterweight world champion superstar boxer Keith One Time Thurman, who's not a big welterweight in his own right at 5'7", with a 69-inch arm reach himself. Okay, so with that said, you know, you get the sense that they believe in Gervonta Tank Davis's power, as they should. Okay, Gervonta Tank Davis, you know, is a great athlete, explosive with a beautiful left hand, puts his combinations together beautiful. Has a high ring IQ. I don't think he gets enough credit for his ring IQ and his boxing ability because of the knockouts and the manner he knocks out his opponents. So I think that gets overlooked. But at the end of the day, okay, I just truly think that, you know, you have to take into consideration these Sean Porter takes punches on a regular basis from welterweights and light heavyweights and super middleweights, okay? As Kenny Porter let it be known that he also sparred with Andre Durrell, okay, who's a 168-pounder, okay? He also sparred with Dennis Dugan, right? So these guys are 154, 160, 168-pounders. They're big welterweight, big boxers, okay? And so Sean Porter did not give it his all. As Barry Hunter stated, as Kenny Porter stated, they weren't there to prove a point to one another. They were there to work on things, okay? And iron sharpens iron. So with that said, you have to take into consideration. Sometimes sparring sessions are overblown. There's fighters that have success against a certain level of fighters, and then they feel like, well, they could do that under the lights, okay? The most famous one is Paul Spadafora having success against Floyd Mayweather, and that led people to believe that Paul Spadafora could beat Floyd Mayweather under the lights, okay? You had Mitch Green, who was a sparring partner of Mike Tyson, and people thought that Mitch Green could beat Mike Tyson because he had a lot of success against Mike Tyson in sparring. Well, we saw how that turned out under the lights, okay? So it's a misconception. It's misleading what takes place in sparring because you have some guys that may go 1,000%, and then some guys is only there to do, you know, and work on things, okay? They're only strategizing. You have to believe that Sean Porter did not step on the gas when he was sparring Gervonta Tank Davis, okay? Now, Sean Porter is a very hard worker, but I'm sure he was working on tactics. He was working on trying to, you know, avoid the left hand of Gervonta Tank Davis as he would see fit when you get in the ring with Terrence Crawford. Terrence Crawford has a 7-inch arm reach advantage over Gervonta Tank Davis at 74 inches, right? So Terrence Crawford has extremely, extremely long arms, okay? Terrence Crawford is also 5'8", so he's 3 inches taller than Gervonta Tank Davis. It's the strategy part, okay? It's strategic. So Sean Porter could overwhelm Gervonta Tank Davis if he so chooses. Now, Gervonta Tank Davis, I have no doubt. His skill set, he's very strong, you know, in stature. You know, he has power. But it's nothing that Sean Porter has not seen, okay? Sean Porter has taken some of the biggest punches from Errol Spence, who's 5'9½", you know, 72-inch arm reach. And I'm sure at fight night, Errol Spence weighs upwards of 155 to 160 pounds, okay? And is in shape. You know, he took shots from Keith Thurman. You know, he took big punches from Kell Brook. Sean Porter took punches from Danny Garcia. These are some of the biggest punches from big guys that you can find, okay? So I'm sure technically and skill-wise, Gervonta Tank Davis can hold his own. But in the same token, you have to keep in mind, Sean Porter was in there strategically sparring, okay? Sean Porter was not in there mashing the gas 1,000% as he would do under the light. So, yes, Gervonta Tank Davis sparring. You hear rumors and reports that Gervonta Tank Davis stops heavyweights. He stopped light heavyweights, right? You know, the magnitude of those fighters, the level of those fighters may not be the same. You put Sean Porter under the lights, fight night, against Gervonta Tank Davis in the ring, and it's going to look like a completely different story. I promise you that, okay? Sean Porter is much stronger than Javonte Tank Davis. He's a great athlete, okay? It's a different level of boxing, okay? So for all the people that's running rampant with the Sean Porter that dominated by Javonte Tank Davis, is sparring is strategic. And I know a lot of people want to label Javonte Tank Davis as being a small guy, having success against big Sean Porter. Well, Sean Porter is not the biggest welterweight, and Javonte Tank Davis is high in weight right now, currently. So we got to see, you know, what's next for Javonte Tank Davis. Not to mention Javonte Tank Davis, again, he, you know, struggled in the first half of the fight against Mario Barrios. His height, his range, his boxing ability, his size, okay? Now, he did figure it out, and he did weather the storm. And as I stated, I don't think he gets enough credit for his boxing IQ. But he did struggle with a guy who was a junior welterweight, naturally, and coming in possibly about 155, 160 pounds, okay? Now, imagine Sean Porter on that night. It's a completely different story under the lights. Javonte Tank Davis' skill set is very high. Sean Porter's skill set is very high. And I believe it was all strategic. But we would love to see Javonte Tank Davis against better opposition as well. So we got to see him in under the lights when it counts with better opposition. Isaac Pitbull Cruz is tailor-made for Javonte Tank Davis. Leo Santa Cruz style is tailor-made for Javonte Tank Davis. Mario Barrio style is tailor-made for Javonte Tank Davis. We got to see him in the ring with guys' style. It's not tailor-made for Javonte Tank Davis. So let's see how this unfolds in the future. That's all I got for y'all. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue. Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV. All one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share the videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
Oh, it is your boy Jaden Kiss. Make sure you check out Blue Blood Sports TV. It's going down.